Hello, learners. Found us look at the purchasing of beverages. And earlier we had looked at the purchasing of food and we found that there are different methods of purchasing food. So we talked about the cash and carry, we talked about the store to supply. So now we want today to look at the purchasing of beverages. And the purchasing of alcoholic and non-alcoholic beverages, like that of foodstuff, has the aim to purchase the very best quality items at the lowest price for specified purpose. For example, you'll find that the beverages are classified in two ways. We have the alcoholic and the non-alcoholic beverages. And when the purchasing of beverage is being taken, the following people are supposed to be there. We are supposed to have the purchasing manager, the food and beverage manager, the head seller man, and the head waiter man. So, when purchasing beverages, it is important to bear in mind that expensive products do not guarantee superior quality, because we when we were looking at the supplier rating, we talked about we rate the supplier according to the price performance, delivery performance, and the quality performance. So we talked, when we are looking at the prices, we say there are different suppliers who are supplying the same product, but they are specialists in different products. One is specialized on the better quality at a higher prices, and another one in a poor quality at a lower prices. And another thing, when purchasing beverages, the following points are generally noticeable. One, there are fewer and often restricted sources of supply. For example, the wine agencies, the Kenya breweries, and the Coca-Cola. That is in our country, Kenya. Number two, the value of beverages purchases. The beverages are not cheap. They are expensive. As we said, we no longer use the word cheap. We say affordable. The beverages are not affordable. They are very expensive. Number three, the free advice and assistance with purchasing is given by the wine and spirit trade. You have seen those adverts saying that under 18 should not take. So those are the free advices that are being given by the suppliers. The advertisement about the new product that have come. The suppliers will give this advertisement free of charge to the sellers. Another thing, the quality factors are difficult to evaluate and they require special training to identify them. You have had people having the testing, wine tasting competitions, and also there are wine tasting classes where people go and train on how to taste different beverages, because if you're not familiar with them, you'll send the wrong product to the customers. Number five, there are fewer standard purchasing units than for foods. The beverages will be bought in terms of bottles and also the cases. But when it comes to the food, we are going to buy them in the kilograms, liters, milliliters. So there are variety. Number six, there is an established standard of products. For example, many items like spirit will have a standard that will not vary over the years, whereas the food items there may be several grades and wide range of ungraded items available. By seven, food items may be purchased in different forms. For example, you can buy them fresh, chilled, frozen, and canned. But for beverages, the varieties are not there. Number eight, the prices of alcoholic beverages do not fluctuate to the extent that food prices do. For example, nowadays the Coca-Cola soda, the 300 ml is being sold at 30 shillings, the smallest bottle. That price has been there for a long time. Does not fluctuate as for the food does. Tomorrow you'll hear the liquid oil is liquid cooking oil is being sold at 100 shillings. Following day is being sold at 200 shillings. So the prices keeps on fluctuating. Sorry. Purchasing methods of beverages. There are three main methods of purchasing beverages. The first one is the wine shippers. Who are the wine shippers? These are the firms that purchase wine in the country of origin and ship it to whatever country it is to be sold. Usually, the shippers is concerned with the wine from a particular region And this means that the range of products that he has to sell is limited. The product of wine shippers are usually bought from wine and spirit wholesalers. The frequency of delivery is limited. So the first method of purchasing beverages, you can buy them from the wine shippers. Number two, the wholesalers. Who are the wholesalers? Wholesalers buy products from large wine and brewery companies and offer a very wide range of beverages as well as a regular delivery service to the caterer. As beverage supply industry is highly competitive, wholesalers offer the following services to the selected clients. For example, suspended debt. In this case, the supplier would invoice the caterer for his initial seller stock purchases, but will request payment only on the following: the first purchase invoice being suspended until the account is closed with the supplier. A way of buying beverages another wholesaler. Number two, seller inventory. The supplier will stock the caterer seller to an agreed level for a specific period of time, free of charge. The opening stock level is being recorded by the supplier and the caterer. A stock take is meant by both parties and all times are used then paid for. The supplier then makes a delivery to replenish the to replenish the stock level to the levels first agreed upon. Then publicity material. This is where wholesalers assist in printing of wine lists and publicity materials for promotional events, for example, the Coca-Cola posters. You have seen those posters in the different kiosk, in different establishment where the wines is being sold. Then there is a disadvantages of buying people from the wholesalers. One, lack of specialist knowledge and advice. Number two, prices are not competitive. Number three, the sales representative are the ones seen by the caterer, not owners or of the company. Then number three method of purchasing beverages is the beverage manufacturers. This method of purchasing is used when the purchasing manager is able to buy in large quantities to deal with manufacturers. This is mostly common practice for the purchasing of the commonly used spirits, minerals, and beers. The advantage to the caterer is the lower price that he would have to pay as compared to purchasing through wholesalers because discounts are given. Now, the beverages manufacturers are the one manufacturing the beverages. And the last one method is the purchasing through cash and carry. Over a very limited range of spirits, wines, and beers at a very competitive prices, they are usually in emergencies or when special offers are being made. So those are the four method of purchasing beverages. We have the wine shippers, wholesalers, beverage manufacturers, and the cash and carry. Those are the four methods that you can purchase the beverages. Now we look at the purchasing specification for beverages. The purpose of purchasing specification is to set down in writing the standard of a product for a specific use by an establishment. This is then used by a purchasing manager to inform suppliers exactly what is required, and it's important when negotiating prices. It is also important to the receiving and seller department staff to know what to accept when deliveries are being made. Unlike purchasing specification for food, specification for beverages are simpler to write and understand. The reason being that are sold and purchased by the brand name, label of the product, each has a consistent quality and quantity of contents of each selling units, or for example, the bottles. Look at the food and beverage ordering procedure. One, you need to write that requisition. A requisition is a list of what you require. Then, number step two is the preparation of orders. Preparation of orders from the various user departments is done. A summary of all orders or order items done The purchasing officer determines the method of